Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success. We are starting a new course on fluid structure interaction using COMSOL multiphysics. In this course, we will talk about a few research problems which needs fluid structure interaction and how to tackle those problems, how exactly fluid structure interaction comes into picture and what are the opportunities with this particular module. That will be the main targets of this particular series. So today we will talk very briefly about how fluid structure interaction works, what are the fundamental physics and what are the cautions needed when we start working with FSI in COMSOL multiphysics. So here there is a fundamental model given by COMSOL, so you can find it on website or on their application library. This problem is the fundamental problem of fluid structure interaction, that is interaction of flow with a particular object. So this is the object which is interacting with the flowing medium, and because of the stress which is applied on this particular object, it can actually tilt. So this part is fixed at the bottom, it is fixed, but on top, based on the stress which it experiences or hydrodynamic stress which is experienced by this particular object, it can move. So this is the problem they have tackled. To tackle this particular problem, they have basically solved momentum equation. So why momentum equation is necessary? Because there is a flow outside this particular object, and in order to take care of the flow profile, to identify, to quantify the flow field, we need to solve this momentum equation, and the expression for the momentum equation is given here. So this is similar to Navier-Stokes equation along with the this is similar to momentum equation. Basically, in a particular assumption limit, it could be Navier-Stokes equation along with this continuity equation. So here you can see there is additional force term which can be appearing in this momentum equation, and the additional force term could be from any other external force field. So this particular set of equations basically solve for the fluid flow. Now that fluid has to interact, or the flowing fluid has to interact with the solid object, and how that is tackled, this is the heart of fluid structure interaction or FSI. So in this particular PDF they have also given that interaction. So they are basically solving another equation, or the force which is being experienced by the object which is under FSI. So this is the force term, say FT, and the force term is calculated by, you can see, the N dot the hydrodynamic stress. So N is the perpendicular or unit vector normal to the surface. So the object which is experiencing the stress, the normal vector on that surface dot product of hydrodynamic stress. So this one is minus P into I tensor and eta into the this one is gradient of U, and transpose of gradient of U, we know this is hydrodynamic stress. So this particular term is used to calculate the force on the object, and this force term is actually added with solid mechanics equation. So what does solid mechanics equation do? The solid mechanics equation take care of the deformation of the object under this particular force field. So this force field is coming from the hydrodynamic stress. If there is no fluid flow, there will be no hydrodynamic stress, or it will be zero. In that case, there will be no movement of the object. But if there is a flow, then there will be a hydrodynamic stress. It will be acting on the surface normally, and as it is acting normally, the force is calculated by normal vector dot product of the hydrodynamic stress. We'll take care of those equations in actual FSI related problems, just to show you how the remeshing is done. Remeshing is one important aspect in FSI. So what happens, this particular object, this is not fixed at some particular location. Maybe we are trying to locate physics around this particular object, but as this particular object is not having a fixed location, it is moving with respect to time, the mesh has to also change, because As this object is a particular position for a time t, say, around this particular location, there needs to be defined meshes. And again, maybe some other time, this object may come to this particular position. So this refined mesh that time has to come along with the object. So this is the fundamental idea of remeshing, and it is also called moving mesh, because as the mesh is not constant, its position is moving. That is why it is called remeshing or moving mesh. And we will also see the fundamental and underlying physics behind moving mesh. It also has certain velocity, with what velocity the mesh is moving. Everything matters when we do FSI. So quantitatively we will try to understand how it affects the physics if we have a better moving mesh, if we have a higher mesh moving velocity. All those things we'll try to accommodate in upcoming videos with specific examples. So you are going to learn those things and you can implement those objects for research problems. I give you a few examples, like if you want to track motion of particles under certain force field, maybe the particle is moving under, so it could be an optical force, it could be a hydrodynamic field force, it could be magnetic field force. So if you can actually put those forces in the Navier-Stokes equation and why FSI, if we calculate the stress on the object, that could give you actual movement of the particles. This is one research problem. There are another problems, like suppose you are implanting certain external object inside cell, and that external object is subjected to external vibrations, and you want to see how the vibration inside the cell happens and how it changes the physiological scenario inside the cell. So this kind of problems can be tackled using FSI. Maybe a few I will be taking and I will just show how to solve those research related problems. So we stop here today. This was very fundamental thing. You can go through this particular PDF because this is the fundamental one, and then we'll slowly learn about modeling research problems with FSI.